nothing, and we mean absolutely nothing, looks better than an outstanding goal. Think about it. The beautiful thing about screamers is that no matter how many times you watch them, they never become a boring spectacle of human brilliance. So today, we'll look at some of the greatest goals in Premier League history. We start with a freak of a goal scored by former Everton goalkeeper Tim Howard. Now, shot stoppers are normally more worried about the defensive side of things, but a combination of the Bolton keeper standing way off his line, a windy day in Merseyside, and Howard's purely American ability of punting the ball as far as he could give you a goal that's as rare as a hen's teeth. Young Min Son has been quite an export from South Korea and has already scored some amazing goals. But this goal against West Ham United was a real banger. Watch how he keeps five defenders at bay, and through sheer pace, technique, and willpower, gets a one-on-one audience with the keeper, with the outcome being one of the greatest solo goals in Premier League history. For some reason, Giroud doesn't get the respect he deserves. A few years ago, in a league game against Crystal Palace, the Frenchman scored a goal that outlined something we knew all along. It was a back-heel finish, and something very few people can execute. Giroud's always been a fine striker, he just had to prove it again and again. Okay, it seems the players love scoring screamers against Palace, because this one scored by Dele Alli is just too good to be seen just once. Just look at how he controls the ball with his thigh and then flicks it away from the defender. And then look at this volley. The execution is so lazy that it looks so good. The keeper could have stopped it, but we're sure he was too focused on understanding how the ex-Spurs man made his teammate look like a schoolboy. This goal, scored by the Arsenal legend Dennis Bergkamp, is one for the history books, because you need composure, spatial awareness, and most importantly, a huge set of cojones to evade a defender with your back to the goal like that. And the Dutchman had all that in the bag. How good was the finish?
I just think to myself, don't shoot.
Vinny, pass me the ball.
Don't do this, Vinny, please, don't do this, just pass the ball, please.
I've not come this far in my career for young players to tell me whether I can take a shot or not.
In his last season at City, Vincent Kompany had to deal with a lot of injuries. However, that didn't stop him from starting the all-important game which the citizens needed to win. With the game locked at 0-0, Kompany found some space. His teammates were asking for a pass, but the Belgian decided to go for glory. Did not have a chance. Lamella never really got going at Tottenham, but there was always a great goal now and then. In a hotly contested North London derby, the Argentine did something only he could. Lamella decided to go for an outrageous Rabona. No one was expecting it, but full marks for the ingenuity. During his time at Manchester United, Cristiano Ronaldo became one of the best players of all time. Under Sir Alex Ferguson, he grew from strength to strength. And obviously, we were treated to some worldies along the way, including this sensational free kick, which left David James rooted to the spot. And even if the Englishman had tried to stop it, it wouldn't have been possible. That's how perfect the technique was. Bale's last season at Tottenham was his finest, because he scored so many great goals during that campaign. However, his winner against West Ham was quite something. The best thing about this goal was that the defenders knew exactly what the Welshman was trying to do, yet they simply couldn't do anything to stop him. Is there a better way to announce yourself on the brightest stage of them all? Wayne Rooney was just 16, and given a quick run out by David Moyes during Everton's league encounter with Arsenal in 2002. Little did anyone know that this young striker would make David Seaman look like a ship without a sea with this strike. 10 years after Rooney's screamer, Papisse decided to throw the laws of physics rulebook out the window. A throw-in reached Issé, who saw Petacek slightly off his line. The Senegalese international went for an extravagant curling attempt from the corner of the box. We've never seen a goal of this nature since. In Sir Alex Ferguson's last season at Manchester United, Robin van Persie was given the chance to finally win the Premier League, and the Dutchman helped the Red Devils to more Premier League glory. RVP always had a sweet left foot, and it was only fitting that he scored a screamer for United. That pass from Wayne Rooney was sensational, but the finish from the Dutch striker was a perfect example of why kids should learn how to execute volleys. We don't exactly know what Danny Rose is up to these days, but the former Tottenham man's goal against Arsenal was a brilliant volley from way outside the box. Rather than going for a conventional cross, the Englishman went for a first-time volley that crashed into the net. The larger-than-life Drogba is a true Premier League legend. Chelsea haven't had it this good since he left, and there's a reason why few can reach his level. Take, for example, this outrageous finish against Everton. How many players can show this much composure with their back to the goal and then execute a volley as perfect as this? Mo Salah has played an immense role in helping Liverpool set the bar this high in the Premier League. The Reds seem to be the only team in England that can stand toe-to-toe with Manchester City without wetting the bed. And this goal by Salah shows that the Egyptian doesn't care who he's up against. The Liverpool forward was marked by multiple City players, but somehow found a way past every one of them before sliding the ball beyond Edison. One way to introduce yourself as a true star in the making who's only interested in going big is by scoring from a long way out. A lot of players have done that. Xabi Alonso, Figueroa, and Wayne Rooney have scored from the halfway line. But nothing compares to the original one, which is considered one of the most iconic goals in Premier League history. A young Beckham beat Wimbledon keeper Neil Sullivan from inside his own half, and everything about the goal was as graceful as it gets. Beckham has scored some brilliant goals in his career, but this one takes the cake. Any list of the best goals in Premier League history would remain incomplete without the mention of Alan Shearer. One of the greatest strikers of all time, the Newcastle legend scored some amazing goals throughout his career. However, that goal against Everton, which was a first-time strike that rocketed into the top corner, was a thing of beauty. And of course, the celebration was equally iconic. Matt Le Tissier's approach to football was way ahead of its time. The Englishman was technically gifted, and for some reason never starred much for the English national team. However, this goal against Blackburn shows that he could have helped England if he'd been given a proper chance. Van Persie is a true Premier League legend. While he did score some amazing goals during his time in London, nothing beats this insane finish against Charlton. An overhead cross that had no right to result in a goal, but Van Persie surged out of nowhere and executed a finish that we have never seen before. While his tackling technique remained doubtful, Paul Scholes was a rare breed of English midfielders back in the day. While he never scored as freely, Scholes did have a few screamers to his name. This superb volley from outside the area against Aston Villa is one of the greatest goals of all time. Yeboah never dealt with boring goals. The Ghanaian was a mercurial talent and people at Leeds loved him. Even if you didn't grow up in the 90s, we'd be surprised if you haven't seen this goal he scored against Wimbledon. A few quick touches and then a rasping shot that hits the top corner. Do we need to say more? Paolo Di Canio, the Italian, might be one of the most controversial characters, but boy was he a brilliant footballer. That strike against Wimbledon from such an acute angle was amazing, but what stands out most here is the technique. One of the greatest players of all time, the Frenchman was a unique blend of fire and ice. And when he wasn't kung fu kicking idiotic fans, the eccentric striker was tasting glory for Manchester United. A Premier League highlight reel is as boring as an accountant doing his job, if it doesn't include Cantona's raised collar, soaking it all up in celebration. And that celebration is a follow-up on a chip that gave the Sunderland keeper no chance. One of the greatest ever to have done it all, Henry was a sight to behold every time he stepped onto the pitch. this goal against Manchester United was absolutely brilliant. Look at how he receives the ball at the edge of the box and chips it slightly into the air before going in for a volley that Fabian Barthez was never going to save. No one could have saved it. Manchester City may have millions and a lot of trophies, but they can never stake claim to someone from their side scoring a screamer that would settle the Manchester derby. That honour goes to Manchester United's Wayne Rooney, whose bicycle kick earned United a crucial win over their noisy neighbours. The reason why this one is considered the greatest goal in Premier League history is not entirely down to the technique. It's also important to consider the magnitude of the occasion and what was at stake there. United needed that win and needed some inspiration. Thankfully, Rooney was at hand and scored a goal that was recently executed to near perfection by United's latest rising star, Alejandro Garnacho. So guys, they were the greatest Premier League goals of all time. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And before you leave, make sure to smash the like and subscribe buttons, turn on your notifications, and watch this next video. Till next time.